At your job, do you ever have to deal with a nose roller? How about a snub pulley? Well, if you're installing a new conveyor belt system, dealing with the different components can sound like you're speaking a foreign language. Luckily, you've got a team ready to help. Grainger's technical product specialists are fluent in maintenance, repair, and operations. So whenever you want to talk shop, just reach out. Call, click Grainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
This is the Jersey Shore's Morning Show with Lou and Michele.
On 94.3 The Point.
You know what just dawned on me?
It's October 1st.
That too, now.
Can you believe it? It's October.
No, what dawned on me was there are a lot of people here on staff. Why? I don't know why this coffee game has to be a you and me game.
Yeah, you're right. We should include everyone.
Not include everyone. Get somebody else to buy the coffee.
Oh, I thought you were buying it for everyone.
Why are you such a goody-goody? I'm already in the Michele coffee black hole, and now you're like, you know what? You should be getting 7 cups of coffee.
Sitting back like I ain't buying anyone coffee.
Just think about this for a minute. Imagine me pulling up to the drive-thru, and I have to put in Chief Meteorologist Dan Zarrow's order, and you know that's not going to be easy, right? Yeah. Can you imagine Dan Zarrow's coffee order? He'd be like, yes, I'd like a regular coffee with 2 Splenda with the possibility of cream.
Right? That would
be
it.
Yes. Then we have Corey and Logan. It'd be different every day, and it would be 20 pages long.
Of course.
Right? You know, my order, I'm Lou Russo.
And my order. Oh, and you were good with the 4 French vanilla swirl pumps.
Yeah.
I'm Michele Palenza.
I took care of that for you.
Did I say my name twice?
You only said it once.
Okay.
No, that's fine. No, I have an alarm that goes off when you say it twice.
Okay.
So did that, that's your,
doesn't
right?
surprise
no,
me.
No, and we have Jahna who would be coming around the corner in just a minute. That's a complicated, what would that be? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 cups of coffee every
morning.
Too
much. That's an investment right there.
And if we have guests, you know, the initial plan of getting a Keurig in here is probably the best idea.
I think we would save a lot of money if we just did that.
I agree with you. I 100% agree with you on that. Can we work on that?
Yeah.
So now who goes in the Keurig?
We go in hamsies on it.
Okay. That's fine. But I mean, what about keeping it? Anyway, you got the pods. You got to have the cream here.
Wash it?
A lot of stuff.
I mean, you're acting like it's like this hard, complicated thing.
No,
it's
not
Keurig.
Not the washing of it. The keeping it stocked.
Oh, that's your job. You're the coffee guy.
You know why you can't hear me? I'm in the black hole.
All right, let's see what's trending. Jahna, what's going on?
So this is just a PSA. If you notice that some of your favorite artist content has been dropped from YouTube, it's not a fluke. It did actually happen. Long story short, it stems from a dispute between YouTube and CSAC. They basically control copyrights for songwriters and publishers. The deal dropped with YouTube, which means YouTube had to delete a lot of the content. So there's no telling when that content's going to be back. But no, there's nothing wrong with YouTube. There's like a whole backstory. Just wanted to make you aware of that in case you weren't up to date. Moving along this morning, your Disney Plus password. If you do not have your own, just be aware, it's going to cost you. They're taking the same route as Netflix and everybody else.
Not this again.
Yes. So you can share a password now, but it's going to cost you. If you want to do the sharing option, $6.99 a month. If you would prefer the ad-free route, $9.99 a month.
This makes me laugh. They're like, okay, we know you're going to do it. Now we're going to charge you for it.
Well, guys, let's be honest. We all know that Disney's hurting for money. Let's
right.
all help if we can.
I mean, I guess we're doing our part per Lou Russo. So listen to him. He's the law-abiding citizen in the room. Okay? Well, you heard it here first. But we're sticking with Disney this morning. This video, I want to know if you guys saw it. Maybe because I said Disney, you know what I'm talking about. It went viral over the weekend. A mom got arrested at Disneyland in California after police, I guess, discovered that she was kind of taking advantage of the kids' free under 3 policy. So when you go to Disney, any park, if your kids are under 3 years old, they can get in for free as long as the parents have a ticket. Well, cops said she wouldn't have gotten arrested if she would have cooperated. It's very obvious that her kids are not like 3 and under, but because she didn't cooperate, they had to take further action. But people are freaking out, y'all, on social media because the daughters are screaming, crying, clinging to her leg as she's being, like, carted away by cops in Disneyland. It's just, it's so sad. It's, I mean, like, how do you hear them crying?
Can I just say this out loud? Because I feel like I have to say it out loud. Can somebody arrest the person who came up with the Disney admission fees? That, am I, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Like, I get it. There's rules and you got to follow them, of course. But, you know, it's not cheap.
When you first started telling this story, I'm like, are they like teenagers in a stroller? And they're like, she's trying to pretend they're 3 years old.
No, and that's what's so sad about it is they're still so young.
They're young.
Yeah.
But, and so this is like traumatizing and you can't even deny it after watching the
right.
video. It's so sad.
You know, just to turn the conversation around a little bit of good news. I'm 5'2". I still get in free. I can listen. No problem with me. All right. Thanks, Jahna.
No one will think twice about Lou Russo. Bye, guys.
That makes me laugh.
Well, it gets a little embarrassing after a while, but you know, the full beard and all. All right, let's see what's going on the roads.
We have nothing to complain about on the roads this morning. No delays yet on Route 9, so that's a good thing. We're moving along on the parkway. All is clear. That's your Jersey Shore traffic.
Time to play Celebrity Name Game on 94.3 The Point.
We love making winners with another round of Celebrity Name Game.
And let's get to know our contestants. Who's contestant number one?
Hey, Lou and Michelle. It's Vanessa from Howell, and I'm a dental hygienist.
Well, welcome to the show today.
Thank you.
And who's contestant number two?
Hey, Lou and Michelle. This is Ronnie from Point Pleasant. I'm a plumber.
Well, you both sound super fun. Are you ready to play?
Yeah.
All right, Vanessa, you called in first. Who's going to give you the clues this morning?
I'm going to go with you, Michelle.
Sounds good. You ready?
Yeah.
He's an actor, played the star athlete in High School Musical.
Zac Efron.
Yes. Lead singer of Maroon 5.
Oh, shoot. Why is he? I'm blanking. Pass. Blanking.
That's all right. This is a movie character. She's a nanny, has an umbrella and flies.
Mary Poppins.
Yes. Best friends with Taylor Swift. In a new movie, It Ends With Us.
Selena Gomez?
No, she's married to Ryan Reynolds.
Oh, Blake Lively.
Yes. Good job. You got 3 out of 4. The only one you missed was Adam Levine.
Oh, my God. That's it. Thank you.
Good job.
All right, you ready? Ronnie, let's give this a try.
I'm ready.
Okay, here we go. She sings Toxic. Oops, I Did It Again.
Britney Spears.
Right. Okay. He stars in Deadpool and Green Lantern.
Ryan Reynolds.
Right. Okay. She has been reported to be the new judge on American Idol. She was on American Idol. She sings Before He Cheats.
Carrie Underwood.
And this is a cartoon character, Fred Flintstone's friend.
Barney Rubble.
We got 4!
Man!
What a great round. You win. Congratulations, Ronnie.
Oh, sweet. That's awesome.
You know what time it is now, right?
It's time for the victory song.
Round the Celebrity Name Game. We'll play again tomorrow at this time. Thanks for playing, guys.
Thanks.
So Michelle has passed me a note just to make sure anybody who signs up for Celebrity Name Game on our 94.3 The Point app can make her a winner. Mm-hmm. Like that, is that?
Yeah.
That's legit?
Yeah. Okay. Thank you for reading that.
So if you think you can help make Michelle a winner.
Appreciate it.
We're doing two things. We're giving you a chance to open our 94.3 The Point app and register for Celebrity Name Game.
What a win!
And we're opening up a GoFundMe page. We're going to help Michelle, no doubt about it. All right, let's see what's going on the roads.
All right, this just in Freehold Township. There's an accident on Route 9 heading northbound at Freehold Road. Be aware of that. We're moving along just fine on the parkway this morning. And all is clear on Route 18 right now. That's your Jersey Shore traffic.
All right, we're talking about foods and whether or not they're healthy. It all started with today's National Vegetarian Day, and then you started saying that there are people who are making the argument that carrots are junk food.
Right. Or just maybe they're not as good for you as you think they are.
Okay, I mean, all right, that might be a little more fair, but look, I ain't eating carrots because I'm trying to cheat on my diet.
Right, like I'm not sitting in front of the TV on the couch eating carrots and then getting up like, oh, I feel so gross. I just ate all these carrots.
Right.
Like, I feel disgusting like I would if I just ate a bag of Doritos.
Sometimes I do feel gross just eating carrots, but it's more of a mental thing. You know what I mean? You know? But now I feel like it's gone too far because in this conversation, they brought up what I consider to be an untouchable food, and I think we all do here in the Garden State. They've thrown pizza into the conversation.
Right, so there's like a whole list of different foods, and they're saying, I think it's like 55% say it is junk food to eat pizza, or 45% say it's food, it's healthy food, you know, it's a meal.
You know what I love? I love people, especially in New Jersey, because 45% of the people are like, ah, you kidding me? That's a balanced, healthy meal.
This is so good for
talking
us.
Talking about.
Got it's dairy.
The fact that that vote is even close is awesome to
carbs,
me.
Carbs, some cheese. I mean, come on. What could be bad about this?
Yeah.
But I got it. We got an app from Suzanne in Freehold who says that she's always confused about yogurt. If yogurt is a junk food or if it's healthy. Now, I'm just looking again at the study where 95%, according to this, say it is not junk food. Now, I feel like yogurt could constitute as junk
depends
food.
Depends on the yogurt, right?
I guess it depends on which one it is. Yeah, because some of them are just like so much sugar and like a sweetness to it that I can see it being like a junk food.
Yeah, I mean, I think if they got Paw Patrol on it, they'd probably have a little more flavor than if they don't.
Maybe. And there's nothing wrong with that.
No, there's absolutely nothing wrong with it. I'll some Paw Patrol yogurt. I don't care. We got another one? Yeah, let's read that one. Oh, this is about the pizza, and it's from Tony from Brielle. I'm going to give a round of applause. If your name is Tony and you've got pizza on your mind, you're going to definitely be pro-pizza. That's how I feel.
Okay.
As a Lou Russo, that's how I feel. So let's
what
Tony from Brielle says. Yes, pizza is healthy. It's cheese, which is dairy, vegetables, and in parentheses, tomato for the tomato sauce, mm-hmm. right? And the crust is good for getting plaque off your teeth. Yeah!
There you go.
That's it.
I'm going with that.
Conversation
it's a healthy meal.
Is over. Tony
Done.
Is the winner today.
I'm going to rip up this study.
Right.
55% of the people who say it's not healthy.
Yeah, they're just going to have to get used to it.
They don't know what they're talking about.
That's right. All right, let's see what's going on the road.
Okay, in Lakewood, Route 70 eastbound, we have stop-and-go traffic between Locust Street and New Hampshire Avenue. In Freehold Township, there's an accident on Route 9 northbound at Freehold Road, and then there's just volume on Route 9 in Toms River heading northbound between Maple Avenue and West Spruce Street. That's your Jersey Shore traffic.
We know it's been a very difficult time for tons of people in the southeast due to Hurricane Helene, and a lot of artists are stepping up in a big way to give back. But somebody who put their money where their mouth is already is I Had Some Help singer Morgan Wallen. A very large check has been donated to the American Red Cross, $500,000.
Oh, wow.
Like, he already stepped up. So that's amazing. Hopefully a lot more will follow suit. We know they will, mm-hmm. but it's awesome that he's already gotten it done already. Moving on this morning. This was shocking to a lot of her fans. They are reacting on social media. We're talking about Ariana Grande this morning. She and her fellow Wicked star, Cynthia Erivo, they sat down for a lie detector test. She revealed that while she loves her fans dearly, she doesn't always like them. And people were freaking out about it. But it's because she says, while I will always love my fans, they hurt my feelings sometimes because people just are off the cuff with the comments that they make on social media. I kind of understand where she's coming from. I'm not going to lie.
Oh, yeah, me too.
Can't be insulted when some people get hurt about some of the stuff they read about themselves on social. That happens.
Right, right. So while she appreciates everybody being a fan, but like she has a right to be upset about it.
Yeah, but why are people who are saying that they're fans, why are they writing nasty things about her?
That's a good point too, Michelle. I mean, I don't, because everyone's entitled to their own opinion. Everyone thinks that they're allowed to have an opinion.
I know
about stuff that they don't even know.
People have feelings.
Yeah, we just don't have to hear everybody's all the time. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
I'm with you there. But I feel like I hope we're all on the same page for this one. I don't know how with it I'm going to be if any of your answers different than mine for this one. But it's happened to all of us. The feeling of disappointment. You discover that little like bit of mold on a piece of bread. And a normal person would throw away the entire loaf, right? Well, apparently not. Experts are warning people. I don't know why we have to warn people not to touch the loaf after discovering a moldy piece of bread. Because there's mold present on those other pieces that are not viable or they're not visible to the naked eye. My question is, who is eating The moldy bread. Who is eating from the loaf after discovering that? Why?
I see mold on bread, I throw the whole kitchen out.
Okay, I agree right. with the bread, but what about strawberries? Because sometimes there's mold on one strawberry, but then the other strawberries don't have mold on them. Do you have to throw the whole thing away?
They look like they don't.
She got me with that, because I'm not... What I do is when I see a moldy strawberry, I throw it away,
right.
and I put white vinegar. I put them in a strainer, and I like swish it around in white vinegar just to make sure they're okay.
Right,
in
but you're not throwing away them works. All.
No. I don't know.
Well, here's what I learned today. Don't eat strawberries at Michelle or Jahna's house. That's what I learned today.
You know what?
I'll bring my own.
You know, you might be right. We might be in the wrong. Who knows? But we're alive.
Yeah, so. Well, that's
there
true.
You go.
That's true. All right, thanks, Jahna.
Bye, guys.
I got a confession. If I see mold on the strawberries, that happens all the time.
Yeah, can't be the only ones who keep them.
If I see that at the store, I won't buy any of the little strawberry things next to it either.
Around it at
like
all?
I have to go in the back? I have to go as far away from the mold as I possibly can. That's just me. All right, let's see what's going on the roads.
Route 70 has stop-and-go traffic approaching New Hampshire Avenue in Lakewood this morning. That accident in Freehold Township at Freehold Road off of Route 9 northbound has been cleared, so that is good news there. Also, Toms River, there's a little bit of a delay on Route 9 north between Maple Avenue and West Spruce Street. Just volume there. That's your Jersey Shore traffic.
And now that I know that you live on the strawberry edge, I don't even think we could take the elevator at the same time.
Really? Are you kidding me? We are not the only ones who do that.
No, I might be the only one that does what I do. I'm definitely not saying I'm right about it. But okay. I'm still taking the steps.
Time to play Celebrity Name Game on 94.3 The Point.
We love making winners with another round of Celebrity Name Game.
And let's get to know our contestants. Who's contestant number one?
Hey, Lou and Michelle. It's Vanessa from Howell, and I'm a dental hygienist.
Well, welcome to the show today.
Thank you.
And who's contestant number two?
Hey, Lou and Michelle. This is Ronnie from Point Pleasant. I'm a plumber.
Well, you both sound super fun. Are you ready to play?
Yeah.
All right, Vanessa, you called in first. Who's going to give you the clues this morning?
I'm going to go with you, Michelle.
Sounds good. You ready?
Yeah.
He's an actor, played the star athlete in High School Musical.
Zac Efron.
Yes. Lead singer of Maroon 5.
Oh, shoot. I'm blanking.
That's all right. This is a movie character. She's a nanny, has an umbrella and flies.
Mary Poppins.
Yes. Best friends with Taylor Swift. In a new movie, It Ends With Us.
Selena Gomez?
No, she's married to Ryan Reynolds.
Oh, Blake Lively.
Yes. Good job. You got 3 out of 4. The only one you missed was Adam Levine.
Oh, my God. That's it. Thank you.
Good job.
All right, you ready? Ronnie, let's give this a try.
I'm ready.
Okay, here we go. She sings Toxic. Oops, I Did It Again.
Britney Spears.
Right. Okay. He stars in Deadpool and Green Lantern.
Ryan Reynolds.
Right. Okay. She has been reported to be the new judge on American Idol. She was on American Idol. She sings Before He Cheats.
Carrie Underwood.
And this is a cartoon character, Fred Flintstone's friend.
Barney Rubble.
We got 4!
Man!
What a great round. You win. Congratulations, Ronnie.
Oh, sweet. That's awesome.
You know what time Never it is win. Now, right?
It's time for the victory song.
Celebrity Name Game. We'll play again tomorrow at this time. Thanks for playing, guys.
Thanks.
Yes, thanks.
All right, we want you to be our next Celebrity Name Game contestant. It's so much fun to play and so easy to sign up. You just open our 94.3 The Point app, and that is how you can register. All right, let's see what's going on the roads this morning.
This is stop-and-go traffic on Route 70 eastbound in Lakewood this morning, approaching New Hampshire Avenue. There's an accident there. Route 9 in Berkeley Township has about a 5 to 10 minute delay heading northbound, and that is, let's head over to the parkway northbound. It is slow between exits 89A and 91, and it's also slow in Lakewood, and that's heading southbound on Route 9. Near Cross Street and Route 70. That's your Jersey Shore traffic.
Well, you know what? At least the weather's turned.
Oh, sweater weather.
Sweater weather.
Sweater weather.
Oh, God, I
win. Finally, sweater weather. Sweater weather.
It's about time.
It's about time.
Sweater weather.
Sweater weather. Finally, sweater weather.
Sweater weather.
Sweater weather.
94.3 The Point, Lou and Michele. Michele, joining us is Debbie from Brick Online. Hi, Debbie.
Oh, hey, Debbie.
Hello. Good morning, all.
So we have these Thomas Rhett tickets we want to give out. And you heard, Debbie, when Michele tried to get me to say sweater weather three times fast, that old trick.
Well, actually, I said five times, but, you know, three, whatever.
Well, we're going to turn it over to you, Debbie.
You're going to make Debbie do it.
Yeah. Now, or was it going to be just three or five?
All right, we'll go five. Come on, it's more fun.
What?
It's more fun if she does it five times.
You hold my tongue and do it?
Debbie, she went for five. I can't believe it. How about you do the first three and I do the last two?
Okay,
if we can get five in a row, you're going to see Thomas Rhett.
And you have to say it fast. You can't say sweater weather, okay?
Wow. Did you not have your coffee this morning?
Are you kidding me? I have faith in her.
Did you have an argument with Alan last night?
No. I believe in her. She's going to do it.
All right. Are you ready, Debbie?
I am ready.
Whenever you're ready, do the three and I'll do the last two. Go.
Okay. Sweater weather, sweater weather, sweater weather.
Sweater weather, sweater weather. Yeah!
Woo! We did it!
What a team!
Oh, my God.
You're going to see Thomas Rhett. Congratulations.
Oh, my God, you guys are the best. Thank you so much.
Oh, it's
love 94.3.
Oh, we love that you listen. We appreciate
that.
Who
are you going to take with you to the show?
Probably my husband. Don't tell anybody. Don't tell my daughter.
I mean, I think that ship may have sailed, Debbie.
The secret is safe with us. We won't tell anyone.
Debbie, that's great. Okay. Whoever you take, enjoy the show.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
If you can, just remember this, that Michele wanted you to do the five. I helped you with the
Team effort, man.
Michele.
That was good. Especially from somebody who was afraid to do it.
I was really afraid to do it, but I was going to do it for Debbie. All right, Debbie, have a great time at the show. Thank you for playing.
Thank you so much, guys. Have a great day.
All right, thanks. You too. Wow. Went for the five.
I did.
And then you were like, and don't you dare.
You got to do it fast.
And don't you dare say sweater forever.
Everyone listening right now should try to do it right now.
Can you do it five times fast?
Go.
That was the most un-Michele voice I could have ever possibly done.
Yeah,
I don't know where that came from.
Like that?
You sound nothing like that.
Very nasally.
All right, let's... Where it came from. All right, let's see what's going on the roads.
That accident on Route 70 eastbound in Lakewood approaching New Hampshire Avenue has been cleared, so that is all done there. Route 9 in Berkeley Township, though, has about a 5 to 10 minute delay heading northbound near Ocean Gate Turnpike, and the Parkway northbound is backing up, and that's between exits 89A and 91. There's about a 15 minute delay there right now. That's your Jersey Shore traffic.
All right, let's both do it on three. Ready?
Go.
One, two, three. Sweater weather.
I said
sweater
five.
Weather.
I'm the
overachiever,
I guess.
Yeah, I guess so.
This is the Jersey Shore's Morning Show with Lou and Michele.
On 94.3, The Point.
Well, the third hour of the first show in October.
Mm-hmm. Yes, we're moving along.
October. Huh.
Sweater weather.
Yeah.
I know you love it.
No, I do not. I do love some October things, though, of course. We do love the beautiful fall leaves, and we do love Halloween and seeing the kids in their costumes and trick-or-treating. Oh, that's a lot of fun stuff. Right?
And all the beautiful farms we have here where you can go apple picking and pumpkin picking and all that fun stuff.
Okay. We got the whole gang here today. We have our chief meteorologist, Dan Zarrow, who's got the chilly weather coming our way. We've got Corey and Logan up in the booth. I'm Lou Russo.
I'm Michele Palenza.
And Jahna's here to tell us what's trending, what's going on, Jahna.
We know it's been a very difficult time for tons of people in the Southeast due to Hurricane Helene, and a lot of artists are stepping up in a big way to give back. But somebody who put their money where their mouth is already is I Had Some Help singer Morgan Wallen. A very large check has been donated to the American Red Cross, $500,000.
Oh, wow.
Good. He already stepped up. So that's amazing. Hopefully a lot more will follow suit. We know they will, but it's awesome that he's already gotten it done already. Moving on this morning. This was shocking to a lot of her fans. They are reacting on social media. We're talking about Ariana Grande this morning. She and her fellow Wicked star, Cynthia Erivo, they sat down for a lie detector test. She revealed that while she loves her fans dearly, she doesn't always like them. And people were freaking out about it. But it's because she says, while I will always love my fans, they hurt my feelings sometimes because people just are off the cuff with the comments that they make on social media, I kind of understand where she's coming from. I'm not going to lie.
Oh, yeah, me too.
Can't be insulted when you're when some people get hurt about some of the stuff they read about themselves on social. That happens.
Right, right. So while she appreciates everybody being a fan, but like she has a right to be upset about it.
Yeah, but why are people who are saying that they're fans, why are they writing nasty things about her?
That's a good point too, Michelle. I mean, I don't, because everyone's entitled to their own opinion. Everyone thinks that they're allowed to have an opinion.
I know
about stuff that they don't even know.
People have feelings.
Yeah, we just don't have to hear everybody's all the time. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
I'm with you there. But I feel like I hope we're all on the same page for this one. I don't know how with it I'm going to be if any of your answers different than mine for this one. But it's happened to all of us. The feeling of disappointment. You discover that little like bit of mold on a piece of bread and a normal person would throw away the entire loaf, right? Well, apparently not. Experts are warning people. I don't know why we have to warn people not to touch the loaf after discovering a moldy piece of bread because there's mold present on those other pieces that are not viable or they're not visible to the naked eye. My question is, who is eating the moldy bread? Who is eating from the loaf after discovering that? Why?
I see mold on bread, I throw the whole kitchen out.
Okay, I agree with the bread, but what about strawberries? Because sometimes there's mold on one strawberry, but then the other strawberries don't have mold on them. Do you have to throw the whole thing away?
They look like they don't. Mm.
She got me with that because I'm not, what I do is when I see a moldy strawberry, I throw it away and I put white vinegar. I put them in a strainer and I like swish it around in white vinegar just to make sure they're okay.
Right,
in
but you're not throwing away them works. All.
No. I don't know either.
Well, here's what I learned today. Don't eat strawberries at Michelle or Jahna's house. That's what I learned today.
You know what?
I'll bring my own.
You know, you might be right. We might be in the wrong. Who knows? But we're alive.
Yeah, so. Well, that's
there you
true.
Go.
That's true. All right, thanks, Jahna.
Bye, guys.
Seriously, the white vinegar? Strawberries in white vinegar?
I don't do that. I just remove the one with mold and then just wash the others eat it.
Everything now, to save the mold, everything tastes like a salad.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Oh, it's a lot.
Mm-mm.
It's just, listen.
Just remove the moldy one and keep eating.
I'm going to sound like somebody's grandma here, but everybody's going to relate to it. Ready? With the price of strawberries these days.
I know.
You better keep it.
Exactly.
I'm with you.
Thank you.
All right, let's see what's going on the roads.
Okay, in Marlboro, there's an accident on Tennant Road near Harbor Road. That's just in, so it's starting to back up in that area. Let's start with the parkway here, heading northbound. Volume between the Toms River Toll Plaza and exit 91. It is a little slow there. Route 9 in Lakewood southbound, it's a slow go between Main Street and Locust Street. Same in Berkeley Township near Ocean Gate Turnpike. That's your Jersey Shore traffic.
Time to play Celebrity Name Game on 94.3 The Point.
Okay, let's dig our heels in and get ready for another round.
Our first contestant this morning is Naomi. Where are you calling from?
Hey, Lou and Michelle. So it's Naomi from Neptune, and I am a loan officer.
Welcome to the show.
Thanks.
And who's contestant number two today?
Hi, Lou and Michelle. It is Andre from Middletown, and I am a line cook.
All right, Andre, you ready to play?
I am. I'm ready to go.
Naomi, you are lucky contestant number one, so you pick who you want to give you the clues.
I want you, Michelle.
Okay. Good luck. Here we go.
Thanks.
This is a journalist, TV personality, recently announced that she's leaving the Today Show.
Yeah, I don't know how to say her name.
Not Hody, but my last name's Polenza.
Hoda.
Yes. Hoda. Super popular country and pop singer. His real name is Jason Bradley DeFord. Was recently on SNL. Peanut Butter and...
Jelly Roll.
Yes. She is the CEO of Goop. Was married to Chris Martin.
Gwyneth Paltrow.
Yes. And we are out of time, but you got 3 out of 3.
All right.
Woo.
Andre, that puts the pressure on us. You think you can do this?
Oh, gosh. All right. Yeah, let's find out.
All right. Here we go. This guy is a cartoon character. He used to wear the shirt with the squiggly line, and he couldn't kick the ball because Lucy kept pulling it away.
Charlie Brown.
Yeah, there you go. This guy's a singer. He sings Stay. Haley is his wife.
Oh, shoot. I don't know. Pass.
Okay. This guy is a former football player, greatest quarterback of all time. Now he's a color commentator.
Tom Brady.
Right. Okay, and this is a singer. Her last name rhymes with Irish.
Billie Eilish.
We got three, and we got a tie.
Ooh, this is fun. All right, Naomi, here's the deal. I'm going to give you a clue, and you're going to tell me the answer. And if you get it right, you win. If not, then Andre wins.
Oh, gosh. Okay.
All right, here we go. Purple Rain singer, When Doves Cry.
Prince.
Done. You are the winner.
Yes.
I love that competitive side. That's awesome. So what do we do now, Naomi?
It is time for the victory song.
You guys were terrific today. Nice round of Celebrity Name Game. We'll do it again tomorrow at this time. Thanks for playing, guys.
Thank you.
All right, you want to be our next Celebrity Name Game contestant? That is so easy. Just open our 94.3 The Point app and you can sign up. And remember, you could be a Celebrity Name Game contestant and also play 30 grand in your hand where the next code is coming up just after 9. Now let's see how things are doing on the roads.
In Marlboro, Tennant Road is closed due to a bad accident involving a down utility pole. Take Texas Road as an alternate. The parkway has heavy volume northbound between the Toms River Toll Plaza and exit 91. And in Lakewood, Route 9 South has a 10-minute delay between Main Street and Locust Street. That's your Jersey Shore traffic.
This just in, we have some relationship breaking news.
Well, we just found out how women start fights with their significant others. Okay?
You said that like a real news story.
I'm turning into a news reporter.
Wait a minute. So women have a premeditated way of starting a fight?
Yeah, I mean, it just got me thinking because of the whole National Hair Day and complimenting other people on their hair. And I'm reading here that flirting with or looking at another woman is the number one thing women use to start a fight. So if a guy is complimenting another woman on her hair, they're going to pick up on that, and that's going to start a huge, huge fight.
Wait, okay? Is it starting a fight, or are they just using it as an excuse to start a fight?
Well, they were kind of using it as an excuse. So if you compliment somebody on their hair, that would be a reason to start a fight. But they're using it as an excuse. It could be a week ago. It could be a month ago. You may have looked in somebody's direction, but maybe you didn't. You didn't even know you did. And they'll use that to start the fight.
It's diabolical.
Is it?
Is it not?
I think it's genius. No. What? I'm kidding.
Hold on. So let me try to have this right. So it's Tuesday.
Yeah.
You are walking along, the two of you.
Yeah.
They're at the mall. And she spots you acknowledging another woman walking in the other direction. She thinks you've looked at that woman too long, right? Or whatever she considers flirting.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe you smiled.
Oh, big mistake.
Okay. Okay, so that does not get addressed immediately.
No, not on Tuesday.
It is put in the relationship bank account,
mm-hmm,
as a debit to you, to the guy. And that is in there so that on Thursday, when something comes up and she wants to go at it.
She wants to go.
She goes back to the account, pulls out the flirting, and that's how it starts.
And that's how it starts.
Diabolical. Oh,
that does sound exhausting.
Brilliant, but it does sound brilliant. It is. Do you really need a reason?
Well, we take mental notes of a lot of things, you know, throughout the day. I think women are very good at taking mental notes.
I couldn't agree more.
Mm-hmm.
I 100% agree with that. And those notes aren't always used right away. As a matter of fact, as most men will tell you, they very rarely have an expiration date.
Yeah, no, they don't.
Correct?
Yeah, that is very correct. They don't have an expiration date.
You can use them whenever.
Oh, yeah, you can bust that out a year later.
Remember that time in 06?
Exactly.
You smiled at that girl at the mall.
Uh-huh.
That type of thing.
Yep.
All right. Well, it's the fact that we know is important to us.
And that's like all women. Is it with women say it's the number
say that
one
like
thing?
Such a warning. Like, and it's all women.
No, I don't want to say all women, but women who do this, it's the number one thing
right.
they use.
It's also pretty
to
common.
Start that fight.
It's also pretty common. Do we have Robin on the line? Go ahead, Robin.
Oh, I had it pre-locked and loaded, buddy.
Wait, so you use this little flirting scheme to start a fight?
Oh yeah. Oh, yeah. It's all right. It may not be the healthiest thing in the world, but I can't help it. You know, if I want to, I want to start something and I want to get into it and I want to, like, you know, give them what's what. That's what I use.
Flirting. You see, like, what are you talking about? I wasn't even talking to anyone.
Yeah.
I can't tell you how many times in my life I've got what's what.
I don't know why I do it. It's so bad, but, you know, whatever.
Well, you got something to say and you need something to start it with, right?
Right. Thank you. So you see me.
It's because I've been on the other end of it 1,000 times.
At least she admits, though, it's not healthy. At least she admits it's not good.
What's what? I love that.
Right.
We've been on the bad end of that many, many times. Eddie left a message. Okay, we got Eddie's message. Got to play that.
Hey, Lou and Michele, it's Eddie from Freehold. And, yeah, my wife does the flirting thing, trying to start a fight all the time. And it's got to the point where I just went ahead and I started wearing sunglasses when I walk around now most of the time.
I'm starting to think that there's only four words every guy needs to remember.
Oh, boy. What are those?
And tell me, give me your honest reaction to these four words. Guys should, ready? Look down and shut up.
That's a very, very smart.
No, I'm kidding. No, I'm kidding.
That is the most insincere "I'm kidding" I've ever heard. All right, well, you know, it's good to know that, you know, you're, and why not?
So if
you
just know about those mental notes.
If you've done something, it should go on your permanent record, right?
Again, this is breaking news. Yes, for all to know.
That's exactly right. All right, let's see what's going on the road.
In Marlboro, Tennant Road is closed due to a bad accident involving a down utility pole. Take Texas Road as an alternate there. The parkway has heavy volume northbound between the Toms River Toll Plaza and Exit 91, just volume there. And in Lakewood, Route 9 southbound has about a 10-minute delay right now between Main Street and Locust Street. Again, just volume. That's your Jersey Shore traffic.